It is time for an update on what's going on in the angelfish tank. So hello my fellow fish fans, I've been trying to do a better job of actually showing you guys my tanks. Part of the reason why I don't is because sometimes I have struggles, but it's important, I think, to show your struggles as well. So I wanted to do an update on what's going on in my dad's 65-gallon angelfish tank that I inherited when my sister-in-law moved from a house to an apartment. She bought this tank, if you didn't see that last video, she got this tank as a Christmas gift a couple years back. And so I believe it is the Marineland tank that you can get at PetSmart. I'm not sure, because like I said, I just inherited it. But I think it's a 65-gallon, it might be a 60, I can't remember the exact dimensions, but I know it's bigger than the 55s. So let's take a look at what's going on in the tank. I will have all the gear that's in here listed down below as well, or at least what I'm familiar with, because this wasn't originally my tank. But this is the Marineland tank, I think, and it has 5 adult angelfish in it. And I am not an angelfish girl, to tell you guys the truth. Like I said, I inherited these fish when my sister-in-law moved from a house to an apartment, and the apartment wouldn't let her have a tank this big. So, because of that, I have no idea what kinds of angelfish these are. I think these two are platinums, and I assume those are just regular angelfish. And actually, if you take a look at that angelfish, it looks like we've got a little bit of ick on it. So that's not good. Interesting. Okay, I'll deal with that in a little bit. So anyways, I've got 5 adult angels that have been in here for a while. We've got 2 breeding pairs. The 2 white ones breed. And then I don't know how to sex them, but 2 of the other looking ones breed as well, but the eggs always get eaten. And then some stuff that's changed since the last time you've seen the tank. The first thing that you're going to notice is this school of cardinal tetras. As long as I can remember, my dad has wanted to have a tank with nothing but angelfish and neon tetras in it. I convinced him that he wanted to do cardinal tetras instead, because they're a little bit bigger and I was nervous about these big angelfish eating them. So that's what we ended up doing. We got a school. There's about 10 of them, and he wants to add a bunch more, a bunch more. Now, if you look real close, that guy right there in the front, see the one that doesn't have the red on him? That's actually a green neon tetra we got by mistake. But honestly, he hasn't noticed the difference, so I haven't bothered to tell him. Some other things have changed, and that is some of the plants have been moved around a little bit. So there was a big plant that was right here that I moved onto the rocks and the wood because I think, and I'm not a plant person, so let me know in the comments, I think this plant is Java fern. It looks like the Java fern I have in my tank, so I thought that maybe if we put it on rock, it would do a little bit better. The algae situation in this tank has been driving me nuts, though. As you can see, we got this black background on it. It came with all this algae, and I just am having such a hard time scrubbing it off. I did 3 days with no light, and still we've got algae. So the good news is it doesn't bother my dad, and since it's his tank, I guess it is what it is. The nitrates in this tank are running at 10 at this point. I removed the carbon from the filters so that I could get kind of the fertilizer in check with a water change schedule in the hopes that these plants will do a little better and start out competing the algae, because these guys look pretty bad. But I think that's just meltback, because if you look at the center leaves, they're coming in red. Of course, the substrate that's in the tank is not anything special. It's just black and blue gravel that she had picked up, my sister-in-law, when she bought the tank. And so since I've got these sword plants in here, I put some root tabs underneath them, and I'm hoping that that will kind of help a little bit as well. Also, if you take a look real close right here, do you see that little? It's really hard to see. Let's see if maybe we can see it. It is so hard to tell that that is an eel. He buries himself underneath the rocks like that. I think it's a peacock eel, but I'm not 100% sure. He came with the tank as well. And then we've got some bristlenose plecos, some albino bristlenose plecos, and some loaches that live in this tank. Because the tank does have some snail problems. You might have noticed that we also have an assassin snail over there. And that's because this tank is just constantly filled with snails. So I'm thinking that we might need to cut back on the feeding a little bit in this tank, but this is what we're thinking here. My dad does not like the plecos, So he wants to, and you can't see them very well. There's a pair of them, and I think that they're a breeding pair too, although I have not seen them breed. But my sister-in-law, Kendra, I think told me that they were breeding. But what my dad would like to do is get rid of those plecos and possibly the eel, because we never see the eel. You guys, it's gonna be so hard for you all. Do you see right there? That's just the top of its head. We never see the eel. All the eel ever does is uproot. Whoa, I just almost fell over. All the eel ever does is just uproot the plants. So the eel drives me nuts, and he's cool and everything, but my dad thinks that the bio load, oh, there's a frog too. I forgot about the frog. My dad thinks that the bio load could be better spent if we got rid of the eel, got rid of the plecos, and then got many, many more cardinal tetras. What he wants is basically a tank that's just angels and cardinals. He actually doesn't even really like the loaches because he thinks they zip around too fast. But I convinced him to keep the loaches to try and keep the snail population in check. There's a little loach right there. Tell me in the comments what kind of loach this is. When I Googled it, I think, and he's literally eating snails. I can see him eating snails off that plant. I think it's a dwarf chain loach, but I don't know. So let me know in the comments what kind of loach that is. We've got three of them in there. But I convinced my dad to at least keep the loaches, but he wants to get rid of the plecos, and then he's thinking of something else for algae control. In my opinion, I'm about to say controversial stuff. I don't like plecos. I'm not a fan. This plant fell off the rock too, so I need to add that back on. It was just tied on with that piece of thread. I'm not a big fan of plecos, and here's why. In my opinion, plecos are something that everyone buys. They buy it because they feel like they have to, because they're like, oh, it's a cleaner fish. So they get the plecos, and then the plecos get huge, and as they get older, they eat more carnivorous food. So they eat less of the algae and more meat, and you have to feed them, and then they contribute to the bio load in the tank. They poop like crazy. They have huge bio loads. Plecos do. And they get lazy. They stop eating all that algae after a little bit. And if you want to keep a pleco because it looks cool or because you like plecos, that's fine. I'm not saying don't. I'm saying that I personally just am not a fan of them. They're just not my favorite fish. That being said, I do get the appeal of something like a zebra pleco. So what we're thinking is take the plecos out and replace them with maybe some autos or some corys. And he wants something that doesn't have much color to it. So rather than replacing them with like albinos that you would see, he wants like maybe like the false Julie corys or bronze corys or something like that, so that the main focus of the tank continues to be the cardinal tetras and the angelfish. So we added the cardinals as kind of a test. We had 10 of them, and the test was to see if adding 10 cardinals would in fact survive, if the angels wouldn't eat them, and we have every single one of them still. So I think that we can say with confidence that we could probably add several more if we get the bio load in check. So that's kind of the plan for the angelfish tank. I also am trying to convince them to get more plants. I think that if we get some really fast growing plants in there, something like wisteria, it will help combat the algae situation a little bit too, because right now all that's in there, we have root tabs underneath the sword plants and flourish, which I kind of have a love-hate relationship with flourish. I'm not necessarily in love with it. And then the light that we have up here, we actually bought used. It's some kind of LED, and I don't know what kind of LED it is. It comes with blue and white. So advice I would really, really appreciate. We're running the light only 6 hours because I'm trying to combat some of that algae. The other plant that I really think my dad would like, if I could get him to come to the fish store and take a look at it with me, is some jungle val in the back. I think would, again, do a good job of, one, growing up in the back so you can't see that background, and two, outcompete the algae. So I'm hoping that I can convince him to get some more plants going on in here. So anyways, that is the update on the 65-gallon angelfish tank. It is looking beautiful. I do think it looks a lot prettier since we added the cardinals, but there's a soft spot in my heart for cardinal tetras, I think. Let us know down in the comments if you guys have any suggestions on a more effective algae eater that we could get instead of the plecos, or you know, anything that we could do about this plant dying. Do you guys think that that is plant meltback, or do you think that that plant is just gonna die? Let me know in the comments. If you're new around here, be sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell next to the subscribe button. And I can't end the video without a little bit of self-promotion. If you have not yet got your fish fan t-shirts from the Teespring campaign, we have to sell enough or nobody gets them. So you'll get your money back if we don't sell enough, but you might not get your shirts. So that's linked down below. And we have 19 days left of the campaign. So we got a little bit of time and we need to sell 4 more. So I'd really appreciate it if you guys wanted to check out your fish fan t-shirts. That will be linked down below. And I will talk to you guys soon. In fact, in just a few minutes, I'm going to go pick up my discus and I might do a store tour for you guys. All right, bye.